Good morning, everybody. We're getting ready for Lex to go to first grade. I'm making this video for you guys from my front porch. So there's a lot of flowers outside and basil too. Basil and spaghetti is like really, really good. So, hi, it's Gamma Ray. All right, so these are the books we have. We have this one. It's called We Are in a Book by Mo Will. And you might think it's fun or not fun to read, but how would you like to be stuck inside the pages of a book? These guys are hanging out. He says, thank you. And this guy's like, exclamation point, what do you mean? Piggy. Yes, Gerald. And his thought bubble says, I think someone is looking at us. Do they notice Lex and Iris that we're like right here? Uh-oh, he's coming out towards the page. Someone is looking at us. Piggy says, who is looking at us? Iris and Lex. Is it a monster? No, it is a READER exclamation point. It's a reader. A reader is reading us. How is a reader reading us? The reader is reading these word bubbles. We are in a book. We are in a book? This is like really, really strange. That is cool. Hi, Lizzie. I'm making a video with books for my little kids. I'm putting you in the video. Are you okay with it? They remember you. There's Lexi. Say hi, Lexi. Hi, Lizzie. I'm making a video. I have all these books up here because they have to learn how to read, you know? Yeah. We are in a book. We are in a book. We are being read. We are being read. Not everybody likes reading. Oh, I have a good idea. I can make Lex, the reader, say a word. You can make Lex and Iris, the reader, say a word? I can. If the reader reads out loud. So, what's going to happen? That is a good idea. That is a funny idea. Here I go. Ahem. Banana. Ha 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 ha. He 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 he. Did you hear that? The reader said, B-A-N-A-N-A, exclamation mark, point, banana. He, 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 he. Ha, 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 ha. Are they making fun of us? Oh, the reader said it again. Ha, ha, ha. They're laughing at us. Ha, 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 they're laughing. A banana. So funny. Do you want to turn before this book, before the THE book ends? Ends? The book ends? Yes, all books end. When will the book end? I will look. Page 57. See, then the pages are numbered. Page 57, it is page 46 now. Eek! Now it is page 47. This book is going too fast. I have more to give. More words, more jokes, more bananas. I just want to be read. I have a good idea. Whisper, whisper. That is a good idea. Hello. Hi, Iris. Hi, Lex. Will you please read us again? I hope this works. Me too. Ha 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 ha. Very funny. Okay, Lex, that was pretty weird. We're going to do kind of a scary one now out here in my yard today. We have to get ready for kindergarten on Monday. Creepy pair of underwear. This is glow-in-the-dark green. If you could find this book at your library, Creepy Pair of Underwear, I think this one would glow in your dark room because of the green. These kind of look like Legos on this page. Jasper Rabbit needed new underwear. On Thursday, Mom took him to the underwear store and grabbed the last three packages of plain white. But as they headed for the checkout, Jasper spotted them. Creepy underwear. So creepy, so comfy. They were glorious. Mom, I think they're a little too creepy. Jasper pleaded, can we get them? Mom said, I think they're too creepy. They're not creepy, they're cool, said Jasper. I'm not a little bunny anymore. I'm a big rabbit now. Mom agreed to buy one pair. That night, Jasper wore his cool new underwear to bed. Do you want me to leave the hallway light on? Asked Dad. Dad, I'm not a little bunny anymore. I'm a big rabbit now. His dad shut the door, and that's when Jasper noticed. Hold on a second. That's when Jasper noticed the underwear glowed a ghoulish greenish glow. Uh-oh. He closed his eyes. He pulled up the covers. He buried his face, but it didn't help. He could still see the ghoulish greenish glow. Jasper leaped out of bed and put on a pair of plain white. He stuffed the creepy underwear into the bottom of the laundry hamper. He finally fell asleep. But when he got up the next day, he was wearing the creepy underwear. Jasper threw them into the garbage can. He was still a big rabbit. He wasn't scared or anything, but he was done with this scary underwear. After first grade school, Jasper was doing his homework when he heard it, a scratchy scraping sound coming from his dresser. He opened the drawer and they were back, staring at him with that ghoulish, greenish glow. He snatched the creepy underwear out of the drawer. He grabbed a big envelope and some stamps. Bye-bye, scary underwear, he said, and he dropped the package in the mailbox to mail them to Gamma Ray in New Jersey. When he opened the front door the next morning, there they were. There goes a motorcycle. There they were. And were those chopsticks? His creepy pair of underwear had somehow returned from China instead of New Jersey, and it had brought him back souvenirs from China. He's freaked out by that, isn't he? He's so scared. Jasper grabbed his mom, Evelyn's, sewing scissors. She didn't like Lex to get them, and she might get mad, but this was an underwear emergency. This time, the creepy underwear were gone for good. What did Jasper do with those scissors? See, lots and lots of little tiny pieces. At bedtime, he slowly opened his underwear drawer. Nothing, just plain white undies. He searched under his bed. He shook out his lampshades. Whew! There was no sign of creepy underwear. He went into the bathroom to comb his ears. They were back. They were back. "What's the matter with you?" his mom asked. "You're so jittery lately." "Nothing," he yelped. A grown rabbit couldn't be terrified of his underpants. He seized the underwear. He snagged a shovel from the garage and he rode on his bike. He didn't stop pedaling until he reached Creek Hanger Hill. He's way out, way by the mountain. Jasper began to dig. He dug until his hole was dark and deep and 100% underwear proof. He dropped the underwear in. They gleamed from the bottom, that ghoulish greenish glow, but not for long. When he got home, Jasper crept up to his dresser. They couldn't be in there. There was no way, right? He reached for the handle. He peeked in. Nothing, just plain white. Jasper smiled and he turned out the light. Oops, I've lost a page here. He turned out the light. I don't see anything on these pages. There was just one problem. It was really dark in there. It was so dark, even for a big rabbit. Jasper turned on the light. He looked at his non-glowy pair of plain white, and he knew what he had to do. There he is with his shovel. There he is undigging something in the mountain. The creepy underwear were a little muddy, but they still filled the room with that gentle greenish glow. The next day, Jasper gathered his allowance money and went to the underwear store all by himself, just like a big rabbit. That night, Jasper wasn't scared at all. As he lay down to sleep, he smiled, and so did his underwear, because they had finally found somebody who wasn't scared. Of creepy underwear. Jasper's the only rabbit in the world that's not afraid of creepy underwear. Lex and Iris, would you get this kind of underwear? So that's the story of the creepy pair of underwear. So now I'm counting on you guys to do a good job at school. I'm getting my camp ready for you to come here next year. I got a really pretty hydrangea making a blossom right here. There it is. You have to take really good care of things, right? All right, so now I'm going to say goodbye for now. Tomorrow I've got a couple books just for Iris. Take care, guys. Love you.